Okay, we're at Aaron's 18th birthday interview. So we got some questions to ask Aaron. Here we go.
We do.
All right, Aaron, how would you feel if you graduated from high school this year without ever actually attending class in person?
You know, it's not ideal, but there's not much I can do about it either, so I'm trying not to look too harshly at it.
How has driving practice been going?
Very well. I don't know what I was ever scared of. I feel very fluent on the roads now. The speed bumps that I occasionally hit in school zones are probably not kids.
Ha ha ha.
That was a joke.
It was a joke. What was your favorite movie you saw this year?
I want to say back in February, I saw Bad Boys for Life with Will Smith, and it was surprisingly good.
What's the hardest part of your girlfriend living in a different city?
Some levels, I don't know that I would feel good, like, morally, seeing her a ton of the time, given current world happenings. But, you know, it would be nice to be able to see her more often.
Okay, you're on death row. What meal do you order as your last?
I'm getting Saburo's sushi.
All right.
Lots of it.
So you know you tapped out at about 3.5 orders.
I'm on death row. I can eat a bit more.
What is your kindred animal spirit?
I don't know. I've been feeling snails lately. I'm just taking things slow right now. You know, cooped up in my home. It feels pretty accurate to life.
Okay. What's your favorite aspect of pandemic life?
Don't have one. Nothing about now is ideal. I don't know, I kind of miss waking up early for school, honestly. But for me, it's going to be having a lot more time and accessibility to work on my music.
What do you hate most about the pandemic?
I think, honestly, how people have responded to it and the inequities that have been exacerbated throughout it.
Okay, what was your favorite outing of the year?
Crater Lake with a couple of friends. It was nice to, you know, have a safe experience, and it was very pretty.
What's your go-to game that you play?
I don't like it, but I've been playing a lot of Counter-Strike Global Offensive lately.
If you can't go to Japan this summer to celebrate high school graduation, what kind of trip would you like to plan alternatively?
Are you using this for actual data collection?
Maybe!
Well, see, here's the thing. I think it depends on a lot of circumstances. I don't think there's really a place that we could go.
We could go on a road trip. We could drive somewhere.
Yeah, but then we'd still be staying in hotels and whatnot.
Not necessarily. We could find old churches to stay at or something.
Be homeless for a week?
Yeah. 2 weeks, however long. Think about it!
Yeah.
What's your newest irrational fear?
Time traveling.
Who is your closest friend at the moment?
I think I'm gonna give that one to Paisley.
What is your favorite beverage?
You know, it might be nostalgia, and not purely on taste, but Vanilla Cherry Pepsi brings back some great memories of Christmases prior.
So the rant was justified in the Fred Meyer last night.
Oh yeah, no, it's a thing.
What was the most inspiring book you've read in the last year?
Well, of all of the one books I've read, I'd give it to William Shakespeare's The Tragedy of Hamlet, Prince of Denmark.
I think you need to read more books.
Probably.
Which three people do you recruit for your team during the zombie apocalypse?
Ooh. See, this is going to be tough for me because in some regards I've already made up my mind for what's going to happen in that instance, which is going to be ending things sooner rather than later. I would rather go out on my own terms. So, you know, I'd probably take Paisley, Alec, and Mia and just have a good last week or so.
Party on! Which emoji do you use the most?
Ooh, I am not an emoji person. I usually stick to,
words?
Words, but also the, faces using colons, semicolons, etc.
Let's count.
Okay. I like colon, capital D. It's just a very happy face.
Okay, so it's a smiley, laughy...
Yeah, okay. Like a wide smile.
Alright. And what is your favorite pandemic fit?
I haven't been dressing up as much as I should, just because I don't go out. I think my favorite fit is going to be the Oregon Ducks Snuggie. It's comfortable, and I don't have to wear anything under it.
What is your walk-on song?
My walk-on? So, oh, like you're walking onto the field for a sports game?
Your walk-on song.
My walk-on song.
For me, it's The Man by The Killers.
Is that why it was on that? Okay.
It's my walk-on song.
Walk-on
song. Who's The Man? I'm The Man!
You're the man. I'm gonna go with Ain't Nothing Gonna Break My Stride. What?
That's funny, because that's on Edward's Perfect Playlist now.
Perfect Jams Playlist? Mm-hmm. It's a good song. It's motivating. Mm-hmm. Ain't Nothing Gonna Break My Stride.
Which actor most looks like you?
Who? What's the dude from Whiplash?
The drummer, yeah. The little drummer boy?
Yeah.
I don't know. The guy from Whiplash.
Yeah,
we'll fix that in post.
There's a picture right here.
What is your go-to karaoke song?
Ooh, karaoke. I like to badly rap when I can. I take some Beastie Boys, but I think just in terms of pure fun while I'm singing, it's gonna be Let It Go from the Frozen soundtrack.
Where do you see yourself in exactly 1 year?
Ooh, I don't know. A year ago, I probably wouldn't have said here, so it's hard to say, but hopefully at a college.
Wow, that's so specific.
I don't want to get my hopes up.
Alright, which movie would you like to watch again for the first time? You can erase all memories and experiences of it, and you watch it fresh.
That is a hard question. I think partaking media is a very interesting thing, because I think my favorite movie right now, I've watched it several times, and I enjoy it every time. But there are some movies that I can't watch, you know, more than once, and I think one of those is probably gonna be La La Land. I feel like the twist ending, I think it kind of threw me for a loop, and I wish I could experience that same experience.
That's funny, because I have forgotten what the twist is. I can watch it again fresh! Woohoo!
Lucky you, Mr. Alzheimer's.
Your next life is as a tree. Where do you choose to grow?
I'm going in the California Redwoods Forest. I think a lot of people go there to experience the trees, and I think it'd be cool to be one of those trees experienced.
What one thing do you wish you could eliminate from your daily routine?
Like, without consequences?
So, to me, it would be the most annoying thing you have to do every day.
Well, I would say commute, but that's not really an issue anymore now, is it? Eating breakfast for me is always just a hassle. I know I should, and I know it tastes good, but when I wake up, the first thing I want to do is not usually eat.
Would you rather live above or below?
Above. Although I think living in a rapture-like world, or Atlantia, as I know you're referencing, would be neat. I do like the sun, despite being a winter person, and I think it'd be a big loss to not have that anymore.
I'm a rebel, I live above too. Would you rather be the funniest or the smartest person in the room?
Why not both?
Because it's would you rather.
But I'm both already.
Which album can you listen to over and over again?
I think I'm gonna go with Songs from the Big Chair. It's a good album.
Tears for Fears?
Yeah.
Those who are uninformed?
And I'd go with Joe Hisaishi's Princess Mononoke, original soundtrack.
What is the activity you miss the most from pre-pandemic life? Wish I had a pop filter for that one. Pre-pandemic life!
Seeing people in any, like, capacity whatsoever, it feels like even casual things, just like saying hi to people in the halls of school, I miss these days, and I wish that it could just be normal again.
What was the craziest thing you did with your family this last year?
No.
Failure.
Okay.
What was your funniest moment in the past year?
Funniest moment. Steel chair history with the boys. You'll find out later. It's coming soon to a TV station near you.
What was your most embarrassing moment in the past year?
Probably meeting my girlfriend for the first time. It was, you know, a little embarrassing, but a good experience nonetheless.
Which instrument do you enjoy playing the most?
Despite not playing it very well or very often, I think piano is my favorite. I like how much you can do with it and all of the variety that's involved, and I think it's one of those instruments that you really can just have that in a piece and it'll still sound good.
What three words best describe your senior year in high school?
Online uneducation failure.
What is the most important thing you've learned during the pandemic?
I guess in a sense, not to count your chickens before they hatch. I think I had a lot planned for this year that I wanted to accomplish, and I think that a lot of that isn't going to be possible now, and that I should have been more not so set on certain goals.
Do you have an example you could share?
When I think of that, I think of how I took my high school experience for granted, and I spent my first 3 years with kind of the hope that my senior year would be different, I would be taking 5 music class, I would be doing a lot of stuff that I had spent the rest of high school being a, you know, good boy for. Doing all of my stuff, getting good grades, all of that. because of that, I kind of undermined what I could have been doing and the fun I could have been having.
So it's more on the social side of the school.
Yeah.
What is your favorite smell?
Cherry vanilla. It's not Pepsi cherry vanilla, just cherry vanilla.
What's your favorite purchase over the last year?
New computer, you can sort of see it.
I'm not gonna pan, sorry, I'll lose focus.
Yeah, I know. But I put a lot of work into it. I think it looks cool, and it helps a lot with the status quo.
If you are only allowed one app on your phone, what do you choose?
I would take probably Instagram, although I'm not a huge fan of the social media aspect of it. I do think it's a good way for me to communicate freely with my peers and friends and whatnot.
What was your favorite takeout experience this year?
What was the Hawaiian place?
Hawaiian Time?
Hawaiian Time? The food was... it was fine. It wasn't anything special, but I really liked the vibe that it had sitting in a parking lot eating Hawaiian food and listening to Christmas music. I think it was a fun takeout time.
What's one thing that you had to learn in school that your kids won't? So for me, I would have answered handwriting, cursive writing.
I know how to write cursive. Ian probably doesn't, but I do.
Time for you to make a bold prediction.
I don't think they're going to teach typing anymore. The way of the future is... I think it's going to either go more to thinking or speaking as being the prevalent way, and then editing later. They taught me in school how to type a little bit, but I don't touch type. I have developed my own way of essentially doing it, and it gets me through. Don't laugh at me. It works. I can type like 100 words per minute or something like that.
Maybe you'll come up with some sort of technique called the AC technique for new typing, and it will stick.
Or it'll just go voice.
What was the dumbest thing you did this year?
I think the dumbest thing I did this year was take 5 music classes. I didn't really know it was gonna be dumb, but it's a lot of work now, and it's not as easy as it is in person, regrettably.
What are you better at than most of your peers?
I would go with writing. In general, I have a pretty good way of communicating. It's in multiple categories, really. I think that I am a decent lyricist. I do well on persuasive essays and other debate-like matters.
And your last question, what one thing do you most look forward to after graduating from high school, which is in just 6 short months?
You don't have to say that. I am painfully aware.
Sarge, get over here!
Yeah, I can hear. I think it's going to be more a social thing for me. I feel like a lot of people look at high school as kind of this social experience, but I think that also means that a lot of people have social pressure put on them to act and do certain things, and I feel like after that, people become a lot more themselves, and although I try not to be unlike who I am, to some extent, I do things for other people rather than myself, and I think that'll be something that changes.
All right, sounds good. Well, that's all for 2020, folks. We'll catch you in the next round. See ya.